alternative proteins. How will we eat in the future? From vegan meat alternatives to the use of technologies, such as precision fermentation and cell cultivation to produce food. That's what we're talking about.
Hello everyone, it's great to have you with us again. I'm Maike and I'm a food technologist at Krones AG.
Hello, my name is Katja. I work as a project engineer at Steinecker.
Hello, and I'm Alex. I also work at Steinecker and I'm responsible for engineering and designing the systems.
Great. We've taken you with us today, or rather the last two times, to give you a broad overview of what proteins are currently available on our plates. Then we prepared the plant-based proteins in the form of oat drinks last time. And today, we want to delve deeper into the topic of fermentation with a short film.
Fermentation sounds like a chemistry lab at first. What lies behind this is a process that's been used for thousands of years to preserve food through controlled fermentation. In the past, this method was used to store food for the winter months. During this process, sugars contained in the food are metabolized by bacteria, yeasts, and fungi. The result tastes slightly sour and has a long shelf life. So we're all guaranteed to have eaten or drunk something fermented: cocoa, coffee, and bread in the morning, or beer or wine at the end of the day.
That was already super interesting. So traditional fermentation. We also brought a few examples with us. Alex, can you perhaps take us through them?
Exactly. When we talk about fermentation, there are various examples that we've been using in fermentation for years. Firstly, we have sourdough. Sourdough is a mixed fermentation of dough with lactic acid bacteria and yeasts. It ensures that we get small bubbles in the dough. And these bubbles give us a fluffy result in the bread. Another form of lactic acid fermentation is sauerkraut, for example. White cabbage is pickled with lactic acid bacteria, and this lactic acid ensures that the white cabbage is preserved and has a long shelf life. And then, of course, what everyone is familiar with in fermentation processes is alcoholic fermentation. In the example of beer or wine, where a yeast ferments a sugar into alcohol, and this alcohol makes the drink long-lasting and stable.
This means that we can now obtain a range of new products through fermentation, which are basically very flexible in terms of their appearance and viscosity. Depending on this, we must, of course, also select the microorganism that we want to use in our process, as the core element, so to speak. On the one hand, this can be a fungus, but it can also be a bacterium, such as a lactic acid bacterium. In order for this microorganism to work well, we need certain framework conditions to get this process in three parts: nutrients, transformation, and the harvest of the result. We have these setting parameters via the temperature on the one hand, but also, for example, through the supply of oxygen, whether we have an aerobic or anaerobic process. So it's actually controlled by the process engineering properties.
Also eigentlich wird's durch die verfahrenstechnischen Eigenschaften gesteuert.
Richtig, und wie du schon gesagt hast, haben wir
Right, and as you said, we first have this upstream process. This means the process in which we produce a nutrient solution, a nutrient. In the case of beer, it's the brewing process from the barley malt, with which we produce a wort. In our process, we would now mix various raw materials together in powder dissolving plants, carbohydrates, proteins, amino acids, and then sterilize them and feed them to a fermenter. In this fermenter, fermentation is then carried out from the substrate, from the nutrients, either by producing biomass or by converting a substance that we want to obtain in the end, which is also known from biotechnology in insulin production, for example, or rennet production.
Exactly. Many startups and young companies are now also involved in this area. There are even the first approvals in the USA and Singapore, for example, because many of these products that we've talked about today are, of course, also covered by the novel food regulations. And that is true. So I think that's why you need so much time and attention to the topic, because you have to make sure that the right microorganism multiplies in the process in the end. So you don't want to get a spoiler in there that ends up generating a completely different product than what we would actually expect as a result. Exactly. And that's where we basically benefit from our expertise, which we've known from brewing for over 150 years.
As well as from the aseptic process engineering processes to produce a safe and stable fermentation. And we'll see what the whole thing looks like in the industrial plant in the next episode. And we're looking forward to seeing it together. Ba 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 da da.